It's been a long, awesome week here at the General Assembly. But before we close this out and pack up, we got a couple more acts in the media zone, and this one's coming in the form of a wrap-up. Because you can watch the recaps and read the feedback, but this is one piece I know the social feeds lack, so relax and listen as I carve a new trail and report the story with more heart than a blue whale. So, before the Tuesday start of the General Assembly, the SG Gutierrez held a climate summit, set to lace up our shoes for this race that we're losing and get moving while there's still sufficient time to run it. Then Greta brought us all to the verge of tears, said hell is near, won't be long before Virgil appears, because the date has been neglected more than 30 years, but still, she left us knowing we can persevere. But the climate summit was more than Trump was inclined to stomach 15 minutes in, and he was beelining from it. And instead of addressing Greta to her face, he took to mocking her on Twitter. Heaven help the human race. On Tuesday, he again rejected globalism, trying to sell it as some noble vision. Thankfully, we had this stage where we spoke of inclusion and showed how the smallest of actions grow into movements. And while I planned to cover more from the GA, I decided there's more power to inspiring than rehashing politics. You can get that in the news, and I've got to stick to what I really know, so I've got to admit I'm not a native in this space. I'm just here as a commentator because I know we won't have time to discuss these topics later. So the question is, how much do we want to wager on the speed of politicians fighting over signing papers? At this rate, it'd be faster to ride a glacier, and I say that in jest. But I'll be crying later when I dwell on the ways we fail to honor nature and ourselves in turn. To burn a forest is to slide a razor through the veins of not a human, but humanity itself. It's species-level suicidal behavior. And it stems from not appreciating all Gaia provides. Look how we rape instead of consecrator. Instead of praise, we aim to dominate her with an audacity that manufactures deadly tragedy. And now we're in a lot of danger. If only we could practice peace, this isn't how things have to be. But I fear what lies beyond this stage, once the fire drives us out the chamber, we are the smoking gun. Who done it? Us. But that's actually a positive point. Since we are the data-backed cause of climate change, we can be the solution, so let's not disappoint. And yes, I get it. We're all afraid to an extent, and fear can breed denial. It's easier to say it isn't real than see survival as a vanishing option. So it starts with awareness, which sparks into action, although, in all fairness, action appears to be much tougher to achieve than acceptance and setting intentions. This week, a subset of a subset claiming to be focused on these issues left some pretty big questions unanswered. We've talked a lot about SDG action. We had the Climate Action Summit. The first few days of the GA were the SDG Summit. We have the SDG Media Zone. I've never seen so many SDG pins in my life. They're awesome. Nor heard so many inspiring stories of real action and so many conversations about how to partner and actually achieve this together. And yet, each day, there was trash on the lawn after lunch and paper towels piled up on the bathroom floor. If we, those supposedly dedicated to action, are doing that, how can we expect to do more? Because even small lapses in accountability, such as not picking up that can or napkin, serve as gaps in the foundation of our daily actions and create negative chain reactions by setting a precedent and signaling to others that it's okay to make exceptions. So we need to walk the talk. We talked of SDGs like number 14, preserving life underwater, but some events at the UN were serving sushi. That feels a bit inconsistent, and you'll have to excuse me, because yeah, it's delicious, of course I'm gonna eat it, but if it wasn't there, I'd honestly have been fine to be vegan. The problem, I think, is that so many stakeholders still see this as business as usual. But who better to reach through a change in experience to show we can't continue business as usual? And no, we're not gonna get it right on our first try. But this is not our first try, and we're running out of redos. Yet some of the words we heard in the GA this week were so empty, they're see-through. And that's exactly why we need rooms like this to exist. Yes, we can tighten the logistics a bit to more actively implement these ideals we hold so dear, but this is where it starts. And from here, we need to actually go out and keep sounding the alarm, that annoying sound that keeps blaring until we wake up. We must refuse to let them hit snooze, must keep repeating this same message until we get it and get moving. And I know that's a bit socially awkward and uncomfortable. But there is no greater discomfort than an uninhabitable planet. If you're sincere, you will eventually reach them. Because the road to yes is paved with 1,000 no's. And you can strike a stone with 1,000 blows before it splits. Progress never comes from one step. And even though we may have meandered, time's not up yet. And I know I focused mostly on climate, but every SDG serves a purpose. And to preserve a habitable environment, we need the interlinked efforts of every single person. There's no arch without a keystone, but there's no keystone without support from every other brick in the structure. From every other brick in the structure, truly. So if you don't already know where you fit in this system, that is your next step at this juncture. Time is running out. We cannot back down. No matter the obstacles, we have to act now. Thank you.